Malignant?
Spreading.
Okay, benign?
It will not spread.
Okay, which is life threatening?
Malignant.
Malignant, okay. So now when it comes to this neoplasm, how you will take your course for the neoplasm, that you are going to see it now, okay? So I just want to say something like, one second. Okay. When it comes to this neoplasm, Shma, so you should know where to take the course. You have a table also over there. So first when you go to neoplasm, know. If you go to neoplasm, for example, if you go to cancer, if you go to that cancer in that alphabetical index, if you see near to that cancer, you can see a bracket will be there. Inside that bracket, they will be clearly saying that see neoplasm by site malignant. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So go to cancer right now. Just go to cancer. Neoplasm table, which is like a 321 something, I suppose. Okay, 321. Just go to 321 page.
Yes, ma'am, we have.
No, I couldn't get what you are saying.
Staging of neoplasm.
First, you go to neoplasm. There you have to go. What did that cancer, that bracket say? See neoplasm by site. Okay. So if I am saying bone cancer means what you will do, no? First you will go to cancer. When you go to cancer, it will say like see neoplasm by site malignant. Okay. So there what you will do, no? You will go to the table and there you will go for the site bone. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, you'll go for the site bone and there you can see in that neoplasm table malignant, primary, secondary, like that they are given. So you'll go for primary. Hey, guys, you're getting it? What I'm trying to say?
Yes, ma'am, bone we saw in that malignant, primary. It is C40.2.
Very good. That is the code I am saying.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that is how we are going to take the course. Okay. So whenever you go use your alphabetical index, if you go to any site or anything like cancer, you are going, or if you are going to some other, for example, if you are going for tier, T E or tier, near the tier you can see a bracket will be there which says like C also wound open by site. So basically, before going to that subdivision, you have to see the brackets, and through the brackets only you have to find the code. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Clear? So that is the main thing you need to follow in your this encoding process. Whatever it is there in the brackets, through that you have to go. You don't need to see the below subdivisions and all. Directly you can go ahead with the brackets. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So that is where it is. So now you are going to see how to code your neoplasms. Now you know how to use your, I mean, where to go, where, in which table you will see all those things you might be knowing now. And now I will say some of the other descriptions which is there in your neoplasms. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So, if it comes to neoplasm, no, if the treatment is directed to that site, first you have to give to that site only. For example, patient would have been having a neoplasm, okay? Hello? Hello?
Say once again, ma'am.
See, if a patient is having neoplasm, definitely the treatment would be given. What will be the treatment given to the patient, the neoplasms? Very good. Immunotherapy, radiotherapy or chemotherapy. Immuno, radio or chemotherapy. These are all the therapies where they will give for the treatment for the malignancies. Okay. So, how to code? Like if a treatment is directed at the malignancy site, designated the malignancy as a principal diagnosis. For example, the only expectation to this guideline if a patient admission or encounter is solely for the administration of chemotherapy, immunotherapy or radiotherapy, assign the appropriate Z51 code as the first listed or principal diagnosis and the diagnosis or problem of which service is being performed as a secondary diagnosis. You got it what I'm trying to say? So, today patient has been diagnosed with the cancer and today he is coming for might be an immunotherapy or radiotherapy or chemotherapy, any of one he is coming today for the treatment. Okay, so in this criteria first you have to code for the therapies, which is that Z51 series. Guys,
what is that series,
ma'am? Z51, ma'am.
Okay,
and your secondary code should be to which part this has been given, where this cancer site is. That one you have to code as a secondary diagnosis. First will be your treatment given, next will be your site. Means, for example, a patient is having cancer esophagus and today he is coming for immunotherapy. Means, first you have to give the Z51 series which comes for immunotherapy and next you have to give the esophagus cancer. Okay, so we are saying why we are giving this diagnosis secondary, why? Because we are giving an information to the insurance company saying that to this site only the immunotherapy. Okay.
Hello?
Hello, please take your mobiles, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that is where it is. And next is treatment of secondary site. When a patient is admitted for a primary neoplasm with metastasis and treatment is directed towards the secondary site, only the secondary neoplasm is designated as the principal diagnosis, even though primary malignancy is still present. Again, I'm saying next to criteria. You told me, right? So you know, right? First two criteria you understood, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And next is if a patient is having a malignant cancer, definitely it will be spreading to the another site, isn't it, Anna?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is the criteria. So patient has been diagnosed with the esophagus cancer 2 months back itself. Okay, and today he is coming to the hospital saying a treatment is going on. For past 2 months the treatment is going on. Today he is coming to the hospital saying that he is having a severe stomach pain. Okay. Hello.
Okay, so
doctor wanted it, immediately went for the other diagnostic procedures and all. Finally, they found that this cancer, no, it has been spread from the esophagus to stomach.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now how the diagnosis will be given, no? Here the diagnosis will be given like this. Esophagus cancer metastasis to stomach. Means primary esophagus cancer patient had, now it has been metastasis, been spreaded to the secondary site stomach. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Got it, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
No sound from the all of us?
Yes, ma'am.
So that was where it is. So here, how will you code? So first you have to code for the secondary site, which is your secondary site here?
Stomach cancer.
So you will go for that neoplasm table, there you will go for the site and below malignant you will go for secondary code. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
And there that code you will put it as a first code and next code you will go to the, where is the primary site?
Esophagus.
Esophagus. So obviously you will go to the neoplasm table, there you will go for esophagus and you will take the primary site code and you will put it as second. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Why we are giving like this? You may ask me a question, madam. The primary site only,
esophagus cancer, and now it has been spreaded to stomach. Now today he has come for stomach pain and stomach cancer only. The treatment is primarily given to the stomach cancer today. Esophagus cancer, it has been diagnosed already and treatment is going on. But today the treatment is given to
stomach cancer.
That is why we are giving stomach cancer. The secondary site as primary and primary site as secondary diagnosis.
Okay.
And next one, if a patient is having a neoplasm.
Okay.
Along with the neoplasm, patient will have the some other dysfunctions also, like anemia. Sometimes they may have dehydration and all. Isn't it or not? Okay, so in that criteria, how will you put? An admission or inquiry is for management of your anemia associated with the malignancy, and the treatment is only for the anemia. The appropriate code for malignancy is sequenced as the principal or first diagnosis, followed by the appropriate code for anemia. Means, first, see, patient is having a cancer, okay, some side bone cancer.
Ma'am, can you repeat the question, please?
Can you repeat the question?
You're running too fast.
See, I'll give you the criteria once again. Okay, patient is having bone cancer, ma.
Yes, ma'am, go ahead.
And treatment is going on. Last 1 month, the patient has been diagnosed. Last month itself, he has been diagnosed with bone cancer and treatment is going on. Today, he is getting anemia.
Okay.
He has come to the hospital for the anemia. And this anemia is purely because of cancer, not because of treatment, because of cancer.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
Okay. So, how will you code this criteria? Na? First, you have to code the cancer, bone cancer first, and second code, you have to give the D63.0, which is anemia in the neoplastic disease. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
But today, he came only for anemia treatment only, but still, you are giving
bone cancer.
Why? Because this anemia is purely due to
bone cancer.
Very good, that is okay.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. So the same criteria. Patient is has been diagnosed with anemia 1 month back, and today he is coming for the anemia, saying that this anemia is purely because of the treatment given, not because of neoplasm, because of the treatment given.
Okay, ma'am.
Means immunotherapy, radiotherapy and all, if they give, definitely patient will go for anemia, dehydration and all. Here, how will you go? Okay, that is where we are going to see now. So, here what you will do now, when the diagnosis, when the admission or encounter is for management of an anemia associated with the adverse effect of the administration of chemotherapy or immunotherapy and only the treatment is for anemia, the anemia code is sequenced first, followed by the appropriate code of neoplasm and adverse effect. Okay, so patient has been diagnosed with cancer 1 month back itself, and treatment, immunotherapy or radiotherapy or chemotherapy is going on. But today he has come to the hospital, doctor found that patient is having very poor anemia, which is purely due to this treatment. Okay?
Yes,
ma'am. So in this, how will you code now? First, you have to code for the
anemia.
And second code, you have to code for the
cancer.
And third, you have to code for the adverse effect, T45.1X5. T45.1X5.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay? Clear?
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
And next criteria, management of dehydration due to malignancy. When the admission or encounter is for management of dehydration due to the malignancy and only the dehydration is being treated. So the dehydration is sequenced first followed by the malignancy, just like anemia. Patient has been diagnosed with malignancy previously, and today patient is coming to the hospital for dehydration, and doctor clearly has said that this dehydration is purely because of cancer. So here how will you code na? First you have to code the
dehydration.
Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Followed by the cancer.
Okay,
there is a changes, that's why this is a guidelines.
Yeah, okay, ma'am.
Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So these are all the basic things which is needed for your cancer course, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is more than enough for you. So based on this, I'll give you some codes. Try to take the codes for it, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Will you?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, I'll tell you the questions.
Are you?
Not ma'am, what happened?
No, they have some doubts.
What doubts, ma'am?
Some overdose profanil. I mean, before 2 days back, you gave the quotes, right, ma'am?
Mm-hmm.
You have sent the questions 2 days back, and we are supposed to do answer for the questions as quotes. And we didn't found that overdose profanil.
Okay, overdose. When you go for overdose, please go to overdose 1 6.
It is showing that in C condition.
Overdose.
Yes, ma'am.
Without seeing, don't say like the C condition. condition, C condition like that. What is the code you say?
S301.511.
That is the code, okay? Now you know, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So we start doing the course now. Do you have any other doubts?
No, ma'am.
Shall I give the code, descriptions now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay.
మేడం అక్కడ కొడాస్ కర్రలేదు కానీ కొడాస్తారా.